As of May 8th, 2022, there are 52 volcanoes actively erupting on the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is pxfuel in the nation of Tonga, which has been erupting continuously since October 2nd of 2015. This volcano is quite unique due to its 3.4 mile or 5.5 kilometer wide central caldera, which has caused the island to have a prominent ring shape. Its caldera formed in a presumably VEI-6 eruption in 1040 AD. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Vanuatu, a new eruption sent a plume of ash several thousand feet into the sky, which originated from the Gaua volcano, representing its first explosive event since 2011. Meanwhile, in Russia, the Mutnovsky volcano is showing signs of unrest as increasingly elevated levels of sulfur dioxide have been detected originating from its edifice. And, in the Galapagos Islands, one volcano is erupting and two are showing signs of unrest due to high levels of volcanic uplift. Ecuador's Galapagos Islands are all completely volcanic in origin, owing their existence to the underlying Galapagos hotspot. Over many millions of years, it has constructed an assortment of towering shield volcanoes with unusually wide and deep calderas. On January 6, 2022, one of these volcanoes known as Volcan Wolf erupted for the first time in several years, generating a series of several hundred meter tall lava fountains. Lava from these fountains then fell back to the ground and in the 5 months since has slowly advanced towards the shoreline. As of this week, the lava flows are less than 100 meters away from the ocean. To the southwest on Fernandina Island, an ongoing dike intrusion of magma is occurring underneath a second volcano. This has pushed the ground upwards in a straight line in the eastern section of the Fernandina volcano's caldera by several centimeters, leading to increased fumarole-related activity. Uplift has been ongoing at this volcano since at least April of 2021, but it greatly accelerated since November of 2021. A third volcano known as Sierra Negra on the island of Isabela is also displaying an uplift signal, although it is less pronounced and occurring over a broader area than at Fernandina. This suggests that the magmatic intrusion driving this uplift involves a larger batch of magma which is still relatively deep. Scientists are continuing to keep a close eye on all three of these volcanoes. In Russia, almost all of the nation's volcanoes are located in the peninsula of Kamchatka. This area was the site of the world's largest explosive eruption in the last 10,000 years and is also where three volcanoes are erupting right now. However, over the last 4 weeks, a significant amount of interest has been directed at the Mutnovsky volcano, which hasn't erupted since 2000. It is one of the most active volcanoes in all of Kamchatka, and its numerous fumaroles release unusually large volumes of sulfur dioxide gas. For context, a high amount of sulfur dioxide released at a volcano which is not erupting indicates that magma is close to the surface. This appears to be the case at Mutnovsky in the last several weeks, as bursts of this gas have been measured at numerous instances in the 1,500 to 4,500 ton a day range. Although I could not find any telltale signs of uplift, there is a good chance that this increased release of sulfur dioxide is caused by a fresh intrusion of magma. However, it is equally possible that the satellites which have detected the sulfur dioxide release may not have been previously focusing on this region. This region is generally largely ignored by satellites, so there is a possibility that the level of sulfur dioxide release has not increased. In the nation of Vanuatu, at the beginning of this week, there were two volcanoes which were actively erupting. However, in addition to these volcanoes, a number of other volcanoes such as Lopevi and Gaua have been at a raised volcanic alert level due to increased seismic activity. The latter of these, Gaua, produced an unexpected phreatic eruption on May 3rd around 9 AM local time. This sent a plume of ash to a height of 1,800 meters or 6,000 feet after which eruptive activity ceased. While no more explosions have since occurred, we cannot yet declare this eruption over. In the last 50 years, three of Gaua's eight eruptions have lasted less than 24 hours in length, while others were as long as 9 months. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.